This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. The thing is, there are n number of DBWR processes are running in database. N means, if we talk about Oracle 11G R1 release 1. So there are from DBWR 0 to DBWR 9 means 10 DBWR process can be run. Now in Oracle 11G release 2, they have increased from DBWR 0 to DBWR J 0 to 9 DBWR 9 and from DBWR A to small a to DBWR J. Right? So how many number of processes are there? 0 to 9, 10, and A to J, A, B, C, D.
Okay. Hello?
I believe this is like that. This is R1 and this is just updated 10G. Right? And for DBWR Oracle 11G R2, this figure reached to DBWR 0 to DBWR 9 and DBWR A to DBWR Z. Right? That means 36. Right? But in Oracle 12C, Oracle 12C, 100 DBWR processes can be possible like that. DBWR 0 to 0 to 9, DBWR A to Z, DBWR AA, AB, AC, like that. So the total is 100. 100 DBWR processes can be run at a time in a data. Now, the basic responsibility of this DBWR process are to transfer data from year to year. Transfer data from year to year.
Okay.
Right? This is the basic responsibility of DBWR process. So DBWR process sees the dirty buffers and take the dirty buffer data from DB buffer 2 and store it into data file. Data file is what? The physical storage of data. Now, the thing is, we call this as this DBWR process is called with following names. So we can call it with following name as well. One is, this is also called as async IO, async input output. Second, this is also called scattered input output, right? And third one is it is also called lazy process.
Okay.
It is also called lazy process. Third one is it is also called lazy process. So why we are calling it like this? Why we are calling it like this? So first is async IO input output. Now, why we are calling it as async input output? Because DBWR takes the dirty buffer data from DB buffer and passes it to the data file. Now, what is going on here? It takes the dirty buffer data from DB buffer and passes it to the data file. Now, in between passing from DBWR buffer to data file, there is a slave process in between. Slave processes are processes. Those are either work for. This is the slave process. In between, there is a slave process. Slave processes are the processes. Those are either work for background processes or they work for server processes, right? So what happens? DBWR process takes the dirty buffer data from DB buffer and passes it to the slave process, right? And do not wait for to write that data to data file by the slave process.
Right.
So what happens? DBWR taking the dirty buffer data from DB buffer and handed over to slave process. Again, it is DBWR is not waiting for that transfer data to slave process has been written to data file properly. Then only I will go to DB buffer and pick the second dirty buffer data. So okay. DBWR process is not waiting for that.
Okay.
So just DBWR process is handing over to that dirty buffer data to slave process and again going to DB buffer and pick another dirty buffer data, again handing over to slave process like that. So DBWR process is working just like asynchronous mode, means it is not synced with the data writing on data file, because the actual process to write the data is for slave process, right? The actual responsibility to write the data in a data file, that is the responsibility of the slave process. That was the responsibility of the slave process. That's why this DB buffer, what happens? Where it has gone? Right?
Yes.
Slave process. So that's why we called it as async input output. When we are saying async input output, so automatically that has to be coming in your mind that we are talking about DBWR process. You have taken the screenshot?
Okay, I've taken the screenshot.
I have pressed Control Z and everything has been disappeared in on left side, whatever I have written there. Over?
Yes, she's taken the screenshot. I've taken the screenshot. Okay.
So just I am writing here. First is async IO. Second thing is scatter input output. Third thing is lazy, right?
Yes.
So this is the thing. Now, as I have told you, DBWR process take the dirty buffer data from DB buffer and transfer it to the slave process. And the actual responsibility to write the data in a data file is of slave process, whatever the slave process are working for DBWR. So how it has been confirmed that data has been written to data file properly? This is the point arising, because DBWR is not checking that whether data is written to data file properly or not, because DBWR is only handing over that data to data slave process, and slave process is writing data to data file. So slave process has written that data to data file properly, that how that will be confirmed? How that will be confirmed? To confirm that, there is a process, another process. I have forgotten to mention it here. CKPT. There is a process that is called CKPT, checkpointing process. CKPT. There is a process that is called CKPT. CKPT. Right? That is called checkpointer process. Check pointer process, right? What that process will do, that process will do the checkpointing. What is checkpointing? New terminology came into picture. That is called checkpoint.
Okay.
Right? What is this checkpoint? So, as I have told you, whatever the data has been generated here, once you will write any query like insert, update, delete, or any query you will write, the change vector has been maintained here. The change vector has been maintained here, and they have been transferred by using log writer process to redo log file. Right? To redo log file. So what happens when this log writer will come into picture? As I have told you yesterday, that when redo buffer 1 MB or 1/3 full, right? Second point, when commit takes place. Third point, every 3 seconds, right? Fourth point I have mentioned there before DBWR, right? So these are the three situation when log writer LGWR transfer data from DB buffer to transfer data from.
Hello.
Right.
Okay.
So these are the three situations
when
this data has been shifted from here to here.
Okay.
Right.
All right.
So using log writer process. Right. On these four situations. So first three are clear. Fourth one is before DBWR. What happens if the change vector data has not been transferred before slave process is going to write the data from DB buffer to data file? So that process is stuck. Means slave process is about to write that data here, but that data has not been reached here. So what will happen? Before writing here, first this process will stop. This process will stop. First, the change vector will be transferred from here to here by the LGWR process. Then only this process is going to resume.
Oh, okay.
Right?
So it needs to be transferred.
Hello?
Sorry. Hello? Hello. So it needs to be transferred from redo buffer to
log writer process to write in redo log file.
Okay.
Right. So slave process is it. If that vectors are not there in redo log file, then the process will not write that data to data file. First it will wait to transfer, then only it is going to write. That's why I have written here before DBWR.
Okay.
Right. So the thing is, I was there in checkpoint process. I was there in this checkpoint. Right. This checkpoint. So what will happen? So a SCN number will be generated here during this transfer from here to here. A SCN number, system change number will generate it. SCN, system change number.
Okay.
SCN number will be generated. SCN number. Right? System change number. System change. The system change number will be generated here in redo buffer, right? So why that system change number will be generated here in redo buffer? Because what happens, whatever the change vectors are there, whatever the change vectors are there in redo buffer, they must have been identified with a number, right? So as to other process are able to recognize that up to which number the change vector has been transferred from redo buffer to redo log file by the log writer.
Okay.
Right. Now, what happens when slave process will write any data to data file? So it will find that what is the system change number in redo log file corresponding to that data which is I am going to write in data file. And that SCN number will be updated on the header of redo log file, data file, and control file.
Okay.
I'm repeating once again. As I have told you, every change vector has a system change number, right? Okay. And when slave process will write that data to data file, it will after completely writing that data to data file, it will find which SCN number data I have written to data file.
What does it need to find the SCN number?
Can you please, actually your voice is coming to me very low. Please ask me once again.
Why does it have to ask for the SCN number?
Can you please write it down on chat? Actually, I am not able to recognize your voice due to net connectivity. On this, please write it down on GoToMeeting chat. Okay. What I am saying, that point is clear, that log writer will transfer that data from redo buffer to data redo log file. That point is clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So when that data has been transferred from redo buffer to redo log file, against every change vector, there is a SCN number, system change number will be configured, means has been allotted to every change vectors. Now, these change vectors are what? Actual, whatever the redo buffer increase are there, they has been shipped to whatever the DB buffer increase are there, they have been shipped to redo buffer and they have been fetched out to redo log file as a permanent storage, right? And they have been assigned a system change number. This is a number, uniquely identified number. So as to other process are able to recognize that what are the change vectors and what are their system change numbers. So these change vectors are to be identified by a system change number, means a uniquely defined number with a uniquely defined. Now, the point is, when slave process will write any data to data file, how it will be confirmed that say process has written those data properly to data file, right?
Okay.
So when those data has been written to data file, CKPT process will come into picture, and that CKPT process will find out the SCN number from here, from this redo log file against this data, whatever the data has been written to data file, and update that SCN number on the header of redo log file,
okay,
on data file and control file, right? So everybody are able to recognize up to which SCN number data has been properly written to data file. Okay.
Okay.
Is that clear?
That's clear.
This process is called checkpoint.
Okay.
Right. This process is called writing the updated SCN number on the top of data file, control file, and the redo log file header is called checkpoint, and that has been performed by the CKPT process.
Okay.
Okay. So it has confirmed that data has been written to data file, and everybody are able to know that up to which SCN number data has been written to data file. Okay.
Okay.
Next is scattered IO. Why we are calling DB writer as a scattered input output? Because it is not sure that data file are on single location, that can be on multiple locations.
Okay.
Right? Data files can be many with against one table space, and they can be situated on multiple locations.
Okay.
Can be situated on multiple locations. So the only responsibility of DBWR process to write those data to those different multiple locations. That's why we are calling it as a scattered input output, because it is writing data on scattered locations. Next is lazy process. We are calling it as a lazy process because when I am saying that I have fired commit and my data has been saved, it is not like that.
Okay.
In every commit, this DB writer process is not flushing data to data file. It is not mandatory that you have fired commit and DB writer will write those data to data file. Right?
Okay.
What happens? The entry of those commits data has been maintained in control file.
Alright.
And that has been maintained by the incremental checkpoint. To the incremental checkpoint. Checkpoint can be many types. We discussed, right? Checkpoint can be many types. So that has been managed by the incremental, that has been written to incremental checkpoint to the control file. And the size of control file is limited. So at some situation, after some situation, what happens? The size of control file increases a lot, and that has been flushed out by the DB writer by writing those data from DB buffer to data file. So means what happens? If what scenario has been created? Scenario has been created that the control file size grown very, very high, right? It has grown to very large size. So DB writer has been compelled to write all those data from DB buffer to data file. Not every control file. Control file is what? Control file is basically the mind of your Oracle database. This is very, very important file. Right?
Okay.
This is very, very important file. This is the mind of your Oracle database. So whatever the activities are going on in your database, all has been recorded to control. Right, and the control file size is limited. So when the space pressure has been created in control file just because of incremental checkpoint, because you are firing commit and all those entries have been maintained in control file, So in that situation, DB writer has been compelled to write all those incremental checkpoint data from DB buffer to data frame. So DB writer is not doing all those things automatically. It is behaving like a lazy person. That's why we called it as lazy process.
Okay.
Right?
All right.
Clear? Is there any doubt? Clear?
Yeah, that's very clear. So control file is basically the brain of the operation system.
Speak loudly. Like an army person.
So control files is the most important file. There's the brain of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Okay.
So I will send a book today, book to you as well today or day after tomorrow.
Hello?
Because maybe that book has not been not able to transfer online. I will also update all those recording to my Google Drive. You can download from there as well. I will also update you. Because just because of internet issue, so I'm not able to do. I'm not able to assist you tomorrow for the installation because a huge bandwidth required for those things. So maybe next week, in next complete week, I will allocate for installation only. Saturday, Sunday, I will allocate for installation only.
Okay.
Right. Meanwhile, right. I will update your laptop. Okay, and okay. Arrange to install 8GB RAM on your laptop.
Okay.
Next is SMON. SMON is called system monitor. SMON is called system monitor. SMON. System monitor. PMON is called process monitor. Okay. And okay. WR is called the process. Now SMON. SMON is called system monitor, and the basic responsibility of SMON is first is responsible for instance recovery. Second is merge to pre-extend and create a big right. So first responsibility of SMON is instance recovery. What is instance recovery? What is instant recovery?
Okay.
Instant recovery is what? What happens? You have three files, right? One is control file, another one is data file, and third one is redo log file. So these are the three mandatory files, right? Now, what happens? Your system means you have did some improper shutdown. Improper shutdown, maybe your light has been fluctuated, so your database has been shut down, so your computer has been shut down, or there is a command shutdown abort, you have fired a shutdown abort. Because of shutdown abort, the system has been down. So what will happen? What will happen? That whatever the data are there in memory, whatever the data are there in memory, that all will be locked.
Alright.
Whatever the data in memory, they all will be locked.
Okay.
Right? And what CKPT has did, this is control file. And this is redo log file, right? Now, when your system has been crashed, the STN number on control file header, data file header, and redo log file header. And this is the STN number on top of control file, data file, and redo are following. On control file, the SCN number was 100.
Okay.
Right, was 100. On data file, the SCN number was 100. But before transferring data file, the data has been transferred and generated SCN number on redo log file, and redo log file the SCN number was 110.
Okay.
Right. So change vectors has been recorded in redo log file, but because your system has been shut down improperly, those change vectors related data has not been able to transfer to data file, and CKPT is not updated, has not updated those SCN number on the header of data file and control. Right? So what will happen? The data between SCN number 100 to 110, whatever the change vectors are what? They are simple queries. Like if you have did update, then the reverse of update, right? If you have did if you have fired any delete, then the reverse of delete, right? So these two entries are in combination is called change vectors, right? So the date, the change, the redo entry between 100 to 110, right, whatever the queries are there, they all will be created or fired in DB buffer, and those entries have been created in DB buffer, right? Like there was insert, insert will be fired automatically. There was update, update will be fired. There was commit, commit will be fired. There was rollback, rollback will be fired, right? Whatever the queries are there in between SCN number 100 to 110, all those queries will be created in DB buffer.
Okay.
So this process is called roll forward. So roll forward will be taken care of. So roll forward will take place, right? Now, maybe there are some entries. Those are committed, or there are some entries. Those are not committed. So committed entries will be data responding to committed entries will be transferred to data file, right? And whatever the uncommitted entries, those will be rolled. Those are rolled. So this is called instance recovery. So in combination of all these three is called instance recovery. So first of all, if somebody asks you what is instance recovery, then you have to tell them that the combination of roll forward and thereafter open, this is called open, DB will be opened, and the rollback is called instance recovery. And that can only be performed by SMON process. You cannot do instance recovery manually. That has been automatically performed by the SMON process. Clear?
Clear.
So instance recovery has been performed by the SMON. This is the basic responsibility of SMON process. Right? So next is merge to pre-extent. Extent are the logical unit to store data in database. I will tell you the storage, so you will get to know what is exactly the extent. Extent are the logical unit. They are not physically exist, but they are logically defined in the database, and data are stored inside extent in a form of block. First of all, there is a file. Inside file, there is a file. Inside file, there are some segments. Right? These are the segments inside file.
Okay.
There are some segments. Okay, inside segment, there are multiple extents.
Okay.
And inside extent, there are multiple blocks. Like this. Okay. So this is the logical unit to store the data. Extent are the logical unit to store the data. Got my point?
Got your point.
Okay. So this is the responsibility of SMON, that it will find it out automatically to nearby free extent and club them and make a large extent to store the data. Clear? Okay. Next is PMON. PMON is called, this was a small. This was SMON.
Okay.
And next is PMON. Right? PMON is called process monitor. The first responsibility of PMON is to fill unused or we can say unresponsive processes. Right? This is first and basic responsibility of PMON. Right? The second responsibility of PMON is to repair.
Okay.
Third is register.
Okay.
These are the basic three responsibilities. Again, this was only up to 11G. The fourth point is only up to Oracle 11GR2 release 2. The last point is only up to Oracle 11G. In 12C, for this purpose, for example, 12C, there is a new process has been introduced that is called LREP, listener register process. Right? So whatever the last point has been performed by the PMON, the same has been done by LREP.
Okay.
Right. The same thing has been performed by LREP process. Right. And above two tasks has been performed by PMON process. Right? PMON will kill all the unresponsive process. If some process is not working properly, PMON will try to repair it as well. But up to 11G, PMON will register, listener will already open instance. Right? But in 12C, that has been shifted to, the last point has been shifted to LREC process. The new process has been introduced in 12C.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, that's clear.
Next is archiver.
Works.
Many times you will hear this, whether your database is running in archive log mode or not, right? So what is put means? What do you mean by what I mean by saying that my database is running in archive log, right? So how I will make my database to record all the archives? And first of all, understand what is basically the archive. So let's assume you have three read log files, right? By default, your database has three read log files.
Okay.
These are the read log files, right?
Okay.
I will label it as redo one, redo two, redo three. This is redo one. This is redo one. This is redo two, and this is redo three. Right.
Okay.
So what happens when this redo one has been filled completely, right? So when this redo one will completely, right? So the pointer of log writer, first of all, writing this redo one, right? This pointer of log writer is writing redo one, first of all. This is what LG does.
Okay.
This is LG. The pointer of log writer is writing redo 01. And redo one has been completely filled. Then the pointer will shift it to log writer pointer will start to write from here to here. Right? So first of all, log writer pointer is writing redo one, and redo one is completely filled. Now the pointer of log writer will transfer from redo one to redo two. This is called log switch. This is called log switch. From transferring log writer pointer from redo one to redo two or redo two to redo three is called log switch. This is called log switch.
Log
switch. Right? This is called log switch. Again, when log two will be filled, same will be transferred to log three, and when log three will be filled, the same will be transferred to log one again.
Okay.
Right. That will be transferred to log one again.
Okay.
यहाँ से लाएंगे So the log writer pointer from here to here. Now the point is redo one is already containing some data. Is that clear?
Okay, that's clear.
Now the point is whether log writer will override redo one entry, or first point is whether log writer will override whatever the existing redo entries, or those entry will be saved to another file. Thereafter, log writer will write anything. So if you have put your database in archive log mode, what will happen when log writer will again, pointer will again come to redo log file? So whatever the data is there, that will be transferred to another file. That will be transferred to whatever the existing data is there, that will be transferred to another file. And that file is called archive file. That is called what?
Archive file.
So archive files are containing not other than they are containing the redo log entries or change vector entry log. Archive. Right? So those entry have been transferred to archive files. When all the entry has been transferred to all archive files, then only that log writer will start to write redo one again. Similarly, same will happen for all the redo log files, right? So this redo log file is nothing. This is containing the redo file entries only, right? And this is containing the redo file entries only. And this data has been shifted from here to here. That has been done by archiver process. Got my point?
I've got your points.
So log switch is clear. Hello?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Log switch is clear. What is archive log file is clear. What is the functionality of archiver process is clear. Right? So right, this is all about your architecture part. So we have covered Oracle architectural part, what are the basic component of Oracle architecture we have covered today.
Okay.
Right? From next tomorrow, we will cover the startup and shutdown, how we will start and shut down, or anything else, whatever the anything else we can cover, we will cover tomorrow. Because, right?
Right.
So I am ending this session today. From here,
okay. All right.
We will meet tomorrow.
Okay.
At 8 a.m. 8 a.m. Your 8 a.m. or I will inform you whatever the time will be. I will inform you. In between seven to eight, we will start. Right.
Right.
Okay. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Thank you.